Here we are, Wetherall Park. We're paddled through the TiTrees at approximately 0.4 metres on the 2J gauge. Although sandbars change every year. 0.4 is quite high and this doesn't really look like 0.4. Although the flow is quite strong. Anyway, hop in the boat. See how we go. There we go. Wetherall Park to Cobbler's Pool. And then on to Possults Ford. That's where we're stopping today. Approximately 11 k's to Cobbler's. And two more k's to... I believe it's two more k's to Possults Ford from Cobbler's Pool. Years, really? Oh, okay. I think you came with Dave and I a few times, didn't you? Oh, you might have dropped you here. You dropped us off. Yeah, yeah. That's right. Yeah. Oh, nice one. You're going to see it. Have you seen the tea trees for 8 years? Okay then. As I say, the whole first day I think we were doing 12, and the whole second day I think we were doing 10, above 10. Yeah. On 2.5. 2.2. Yeah. Oh, no, yeah, no, I'm fine. I won't be speeding. Well, today's the discovery, you know. Yeah, yeah. Well, I want to spin around and see you go through things as well, so, you know. Oh, well. I don't need to race before the race. Yeah, yeah. Well, I just need to pick the lines. I don't need to sprint it, though. I just need to figure out where to go. I don't feel that strong, so I'll probably be buggered by halfway. Yeah, 11 k's from Wetherall Park to Cobblers. And then I think it's 2 k's from Cobblers to Possults, yeah? So that would make 11. The thing that I had 12 on there years ago and I had to change it to 11 because I got it wrong. I think it's like 11 point something, so you have to choose because you got to have whole numbers. Exactly. But you have to make it equal 53, so 54, so yeah. that's coming up. I mean, is it murky to you? Do you think there's sediment in the river, in the flow? It doesn't look that sedimenty, which is usually a sign of a river coming up. It's quite clear, yeah, so it must be just sustaining here, I guess. That's right, yeah. Whoa, a rock. A couple of rocks just under the surface here. What's that? Oh no, sandbar. Well, this is sandbar pool. This is the part that I mean, that I say you ground out on first in this pool. Well, it's less than a blade deep. Correct, yeah. That's right, yeah. You're gonna get over there at some point. Yeah. Even now. Oh, here we go. There'll be a little tiny channel on the right hand bank. No water there. It's all moving though, so it's all hopefully gonna gouge this out. Rock. Jeez. Big wide river for now. You reckon? There are rocks under here though. Maybe they're washed into the river, yeah. You think it could have been a natural deposit? And you've cut it left, yeah, I think so, yeah. Yeah. See, this is hilarious. The heart rate monitor is working fine now, but the light still doesn't come on here. The light's busted. Seems to think it can read my heart without that light now. It's strange. Wonder what the light's for if it doesn't need it. Yeah, this is the pool that looks like the orchard, but it's not. Yeah. That pool also gets shallow, but there's a good channel on the left-hand side. Yeah. Well, hopefully this will be the only day it'll be picking sandbars. Not orchard yet. I think is it 2Ks or 3Ks? I think it's 2Ks down, isn't it? Or maybe 3. Yeah. Still, 9.5 kph, can't complain. Yeah. Except for the wizard. Yep. What do you reckon? I reckon far right might be good as well. Like, no. Well, we might make it through, but it's not. extreme right side there. Yeah, yeah. First obstacle. Wonder what road it connects to. Oh yeah, let's go across both sides. I guess that must be like another orchard type culvert situation. Or maybe there's a road, actual road there, yeah. Well, I guess the orchard kind of was that. Because you know there's that road on the other side, like as you're walking towards the river, you cross the track. Must be the only farmer's infrastructure in the area is that old culvert and track. Little tiny thing. Don't think I've ever seen any farming going on there. But yet they prohibit us to access. It's just around the corner there, isn't it, still? The overhang? Oh, you reckon that's the overhang itself, yeah. Okay. But I'll never forget, it wasn't 2010, but it was another low year. I got out and emptied my boat opposite that overhanging tree on the sandbar in the middle of the river. So it wasn't out of the water. It was about 10 centimeters. It was about 5 centimeters deep, but I grounded out on the sandbar and then emptied the boat in the middle of the river. Well, I think it's a little bit further down because it's at the absolute end of the pool. You know, we're only like 50 meters above the actual start of the tea trees, aren't we? Yeah, it's definitely in this pool though, yeah. Now, I remember all of this being out of the water in the past. Yeah, but it hasn't washed the grass away yet, that's right. Yeah, these pools. These are sandbars, aren't they? Yep. Well, 10 was the worst, yeah? Yeah. So you and Melinda. You and Janie? No, you and Janie did high. So you and Melinda. Oh, right. Oh, that's right, but you didn't start. Yeah, that's right, yeah. Yeah. Well, that was the year that, as I was saying, Terry Brooks was the last 5-on-5 in the race. Well, I saw them pulling over that giant log that was out of the water that they had to pull over. And that was the last time I saw a 5-on-5, but maybe you're right, maybe they just made the cutoffs way behind me. Although I was pretty much at the end of cutoffs. Because Dave Tupling got to Bells. Remember, that's when he got to Wyonga and then he was told that you're not going to make it, so he got to the top of Bells and stopped. But then they extended the cutoff and ran up. Okay, so T2 made it to Bells, that's pretty good. Because usually if you get to Bells and you're not broken, then you'll be okay. Oh, so he was pulled off at Bells. Okay, I see. Like Dave, he maybe came there an hour later or something. Because you've got all the way from Strom Hills, don't you, before there's another checkpoint. So... That's... Exactly, yeah. Yeah, well, it's going to be about 3Ks. Yeah. See how close it is to 11 to Cobblers though. I reckon it will be more like 12, like you say. But then if you have to add it up to 54, then you have to cut a K somewhere. It's definitely 17 to Katrine, 11. It's just the wind, yeah, the wind catching it. I'll tell you. I'll tell you when I get there. Yeah, 17 Ks to Katrine, 11 to Extracts from Katrine, and then 4 to 2J, so it's only 15 plus 17. 32 Ks to 2J. I've got 9 Ks from 2J to Wetherall Park. A long way. And then another K to Wetherall Park itself. Yeah. So 2J Town is 8 Ks long, is it? Wow. Good bridge, yeah. Wow. You'll have to cut across pretty soon. Well, these are the sandbars that I filled up on, that I emptied on, so a bit higher now, ish. Here we are at the orchard. This is the traditional, historical start of the tea trees. Well, it is the start of the tea trees. But we no longer launch the boats from here, because this is private property. And the farmer doesn't like us coming down here. All right. straight's usually the way now. Oh, well, we gotta see. Who knows? If you go right, you have to cut left anyway. So if you can go straight, it's better, yeah. I always get burned because I don't go straight, and everyone says, well, you should have gone straight. Oh, this way. Yeah, I remember it being quite open and easy if you take the right way. Yeah, it's definitely the right way. Yeah, that's the second island. The island that we carry over is the one over there. Yeah, well, that's where you come through. If you wanted to drag left as soon as possible, that's where you come. But look, it's bloody shallow now. Yeah, yeah. Well, if there's enough water through here, of course. Haven't made it yet. What he means, jumping those, yeah. That's easy though, isn't it? Yeah, that's the island that you jump. So that little channel down there is what's on the sort of the right middle. There's still another channel on our right. Yeah, yeah. Well, we should be at that ford pretty soon. Now, this is definitely a better way. Oh, yeah, yeah, here we are, the ford. I think you want to jag right here. Well, you have to jag right, put it that way. Watch out! Nice one! Well, then we won't be able to jag as fast across though, so that's quite... That's difficult there. Yeah, I mean, very hard to cut across if it's any higher. We'll have to come on the right-hand side next time and see whether it's a goer, because that's a very difficult thing to do. As I say, I've gone right every year usually, but it's not really a good way. Assuming the water's going to come up and not down. Oh, I see. You don't care. Yeah. No issue. No worries. No worries. So we'll have to try that right-hand channel again before the race. Yeah. But upstream though, it might be just blockage after blockage. But you'll be in the tea tree above it on the left. So you've got to cut across, way across to get around there. Sorry? Well, this is the whole river now, so we're fine. There's no other channels. There is a channel, yeah, but I don't know if it's really the right one, but I'll take it. It's not the pool maybe that you're thinking of where you have to take a sharp right. Yeah, I think Ducey goes down there. And then there's a big S-bend coming up, isn't there? Did the same thing as me. The water didn't push us where we thought it would. That's a new shed there, I think. I haven't seen that shed before. Look at that carving. Oh, it's a wind vane. Check that out. That's a wind thing there. Spinning around a huge steel pole with the yellow thing on top. Alright, now we get to decide. I think it's all just straight through on the right. Yeah, we're all good. Could go left there. No, I've gone here years now and it's always fine. This is the section where right is right. Yeah. Yeah. You remember having to get up on the grass here? Cut that corn, it's not too strong, you'll be fine. Pow, pow, pow! Now, do you remember cutting through here before? And it gets worse and worse and worse. You have to come through here, otherwise you get stuck in the graveyard down here. And I got stuck in the wizard here once. I think it was right there or right here, and there's just more and more and more obstruction because you've missed the good one. You keep, yeah, but you have to end up coming through there, which it's a bit of a, it's okay. Yeah, you'd get through there. Okay. Yeah, maybe it's even for, maybe you're still on the left side and now you're stuffed if you haven't got through yet. Yeah, because I've stuck right the entire way up to here, including that top section that we came out at the ford. I'm usually on the right-hand bank there. So if we can take that right-hand channel at the very beginning at the orchard, then it's the way. Yeah, left here. Yeah, this is one of the only go right when it's obvious. So yeah, there is a channel right, but it's obviously not a good channel. I think this is where the big S-bend is that gets us back into the right channel. So we end up going all the way over to the left and then all the way over to the right again. And Ducey, I think, takes that right channel and says, oh, it's the right way. And I'm telling him, mate, try that at below 0.4 and you won't get through. Yeah, here's the S Bend. Well, one of the S Bends. It's not the one I was thinking of. Good. Yeah, that's easy if you stay right. Oh, did you get a kilometer reading at the orchard? 2.8, yep. Okay. 4 point. Same, yep. Cool. Yeah. I think there's basically no more decisions now until below Cobblers. Yeah, it's pretty much go where all the water goes now, and there's no kind of. Yeah, well, I just remember having to not think anymore after the first go right, and then if that's okay, then now you go anyway. Oh yeah. That was from a flood a long time ago. Look at this all scummy stuff, does it? Does that mean it hasn't been flowing up here? I mean, it's flowing now. You'd think it would have washed that all down. Oh, we must be in a little dam here. Yeah, there's a natural dam in front of us, I guess. Remember that one channel at right angles on the right hand side of the river, and you have to shoot down at the last minute? I don't think that's a thing anymore. We'll see. Yeah, you're right, this is the left-hand one, isn't it? Oh, the left-hand is super open, isn't it? Once you get there, it's a no-brainer, but at the moment, you don't know it's there. you realize once you get here that it's there's no other way. It's where that log is. Right here. Oh no, other side of the log. Yeah. Strange the water doesn't just go through there, isn't it? Maybe this is the big S bend that I'm remembering. Yep. Nice one. Yeah, so you think you might have a choice here, but you actually don't. All the water just goes down one place. Unless you are almost stationary, or you will be hitting it and becoming stationary. Do not grab branches to push yourself off. Push yourself off with your paddle, or with the boat bumping off itself. Be prepared for your boat to bump into the log. And be prepared for what will happen when that occurs. This is obviously a destabilization of your boat and a pushing in the direction that the log pushes you. Underwater obstructions. Alright, there's a camera. Ooh, nice one. Jesus. All right. Don't think you're getting through over there. Thank you. You getting through over there? Here is where the channels combine. You can see how much water Bordad has been dealing with. There's not a lot that comes out down there. Yeah. out to nothing. Sure, it came back in somewhere else. Thank you. must have got through okay. Yeah, just at the beginning there? Just at the beginning or all the way through? But then you must have cut back into the main channel pretty soon. Because I thought the channel came out way later, so I went down the bottom and then looked for a channel on the right, and there was no channel, and I was on the riverbank, so I thought, oh, you've already obviously come back into the main channel by now. So, but it got worse and worse, didn't it? It got shallower, 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 and then... But then you had to jag over back into the left-hand channel. But yeah, yeah. But they were all little trickles, weren't they? Yeah, yeah. But wow, that top part, that entrance where I came in was bloody hard. So, oh no, no. It pushed, so there was that log at the top and then there was an overhang after the log. Yeah. This might be the wrong way. Sorry? Yeah, yeah, well, I'm not sure if where we are right now is correct, so let's just keep our eyes open. I don't know if we've got enough water here. There's a few more bits to come still. U-turn! Can't get into that one though. God, it's gotta get good at bashing trees, that's the case. Root shoot, maybe. Nah, not the root shoot. That's the high water line. Ah, yes. This is the S bend. Yeah. In there. I think that used to be the way, but I think we're all good here now. Yeah, we're good. This is that little chute. The fast little bit with the semi-rapids. This way. Let's get real front. paddle down and on your boat. Back paddle, doesn't matter. It will be pushed aside by whatever it hits. Front paddle, however, will get caught. Bidding pool, okay. Yeah, it looks a bit different to how it used to, but it's but you remember that little section where it's all fast for a while? I thought that was it, but maybe I'm wrong. I seem to remember it being about halfway through the TiTrees. Yeah. That's right, yeah, that's what I thought. About where I remember it. I thought there's a fake pool above Jimpitting and then another pool. But maybe we already hit the fake one, because that one above where you're saying the people watch you from, that looks a bit, that's like a fake Jimpitting pool too. Well, just before... Yeah. I think this is the pool where you gotta hug the sides because it's shallow. Oh, you reckon that's Jimpitting in front of us there? Oh yeah. Yeah. Well, I'm hitting the sand now, so I'm just gonna concentrate on where to paddle. So I can't see the bottom and I don't know what depth anything is. There we go. Can't see anything with the sun like that. Just reflection on the water. Yeah, yeah. I'm saying confidence and speed and reaction time. Well, just use whatever strength you have. You've got enough strength, you just have to use it and be able to use it within split seconds. Yeah, soon enough, yeah. So I think maybe in the future, let's see if Jules wants to drive, because he might be a, or then, no, but just say like a better option, you'll do better with him in the front rather than the back, or him and the driver. But then I reckon put the pedals in the back seat and have him in the front. And then he'll be able to do all the power things that young people need to do, and then you'll be able to keep the rhythm and steer. But God, it's hard to steer the bloody big doubles, isn't it though? Well, you've got even less time to make decisions if it's higher, so... You know, higher means you don't hit as much, but higher means you've got way less time. You're moving, you know, much faster. And then obviously water's more powerful and the danger is bigger and all the rest. Although 0.6, 0.8 is not exactly dangerous. Yeah, still a good flow down here. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. There's 8Ks down now. Oh, yeah. I must have done a bit extra than you now. Maybe the left side was longer than the right side back there. Yeah, it's definitely the correct side of this pool to stay on. Right side is no good. Yep. Wire strung across the river. There's a wire strung across the river on the left there. Oh, it's jimping itself. Yeah, yeah. 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 There used to be all these dead things up there, didn't there? Was it right here that there were thickets there? Huh. Hmm. Yeah. I do seem to remember something straight after Jimpiting, but I know there's a big blockage coming up. You're right though, I thought maybe that was at Jimpiting. Well, no, no. The big blockage is downstream, but there was a little thing there, yeah. Yeah, this is the... Yeah, yeah. And for years, wasn't there a log right across the middle? Yeah, and you had to go sort of... If this is what I think it is, we want to go straight ahead, sort of middle right. Well, not here itself, this is just a channel, but... Oh, this is where... Isn't this where the chute jags off to the right? Yeah, 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 so... I believe we don't take that anymore. We'll see, but I think that's not the way anymore. You look through there, it's all filled up with stuff now. And that's pretty open. Oh no, no. Let's do it. Let's do it, yeah. It's got most of the water flowing here. So this is a schnooksy little shortcut. If people in the rice go the left and get stuck. Yeah, yeah, which is right here. We go left here. Used to be round the roots of that log here. We used to go right, yeah, yeah, but this is open now. Well, I think it's all fine, yeah. Each way's fine. You got a little bit of a log jump here, but I don't know. Can't see anything. Go that side. Yeah, you got rocks over there. That was the reason, but either would be okay. It'd be okay on the right, yeah. Don't want it any lower than this. We're coming up to the root chute, I believe. Another dodgy, dodgy one, eh? That's right. Just you go, you go, you go. Yeah, that's that rocky one that you wouldn't get through the left. Oh, yeah, yeah, but then... I thought the root chute was around here somewhere. The old root chute. That might have been it behind us in one of those channels, yeah. All the channels will be open and you can go anywhere. Yeah, I got it. Bit of clay, geez, mud. Yeah, yeah. It's just 10 years of no trees. And we've had like 6 or 7 years of 2.5 meters to flood it out. So if it hasn't grown back, then it won't be there. It has to grow back every summer. You go if you want. Yeah, you left back, yeah. Well, yeah, that's fine, good. Yeah, below 0.6, you've only got one channel. But then above 0.6, doesn't matter where you go, so there's sort of no need to practice at 0.6 or above, because anything's fine, Yeah. And at that level, a tiny bit of, whoa, yee-hee! At that level, everything changes really with a tiny bit of water level change, the whole river changes at 0.6, whereas at 0.4, 0.2, 0.3, 0.4, 0.5, it's all just one channel or one channel or one channel. You'd sort of say 0.5 is the minimum paddleable, because that's when that one channel becomes passable. Or 0.4, I guess. Jimpeting, okay. Yeah. So he said, did Dave say the hard part was below jimpeting, didn't he? Above jimpeting? Oh, really? Okay. I mean, we know the bit below cobblers is sort of the worst of it. Yeah, maybe they stopped at cobblers. There's a few of these where the alternate channels are usually trickling at this level, and they're way out of the water now. This is the little rapids, yeah. This is where the log used to be across the river. You want to go middle left after the chute. You want to take that middle right. Right of it. Right of the island in front of us. Maybe. We can take the far left, yeah, give that a try. I usually take the right channel here. I think the right channel's too shallow today, yeah. I've ground out there many times. I think we have to jag right now as soon as possible. That's the problem. That might be the root chute there on the right, and it comes down into this. Yeah. Stick. Looks familiar, doesn't it? Just in front of us on the right, I think is where it pops out. Well, the left is definitely the way there. Yeah, there, that's the root chute, the old root chute. Well, I've gone there 15 races out of 20, yeah. I usually go there. But yeah, you get stuck on that channel right now. Sawed it off. He took a saw with him. Yeah, I think you said that before. He takes the little handsaw with him. He's probably the one that cut all the things in Upper Swan and Amazon Channel and all that. Well, tell you a funny, on one of the official, I forget where it was, but somebody said, oh, don't worry. worry about those trees, someone will saw them off before the race. And I thought, are they saying that officially you're allowed to go and do that? Like, are they saying that people just do that every year because it's... they don't. I think I've seen it maybe 3 times or 4 times in total, you know. I mean, in the tea trees, I don't think I've ever seen a tree cut down with a saw. And Death House, I mean, we're 10.1 k's, so we should be only like half a k or maybe a k. Oh yeah, probably 1.5 k's to Cobblers now. Yeah, otherwise we'd be almost at Leatherheads, wouldn't we? Yeah, that gauge has been long gone, but the tree that you used to smash into when the gauge was on, I think is still there. But that's the pool above Leatherheads, isn't it? Don't you hit that gauge and then you're in a pool after that. And then another pool before Leatherheads, is it? And that's not the pool below the gauge. Okay, yeah. Maybe it's gone, yeah. We didn't see it driving up either. Oh, okay. Yeah. And then there's another half of it still coming, isn't there? You know how you identify places on the river? I think you told me this years ago. You look at the hill in the background. That never changes. There's that gauge which means nothing to us. Looks like that's just washed there though. Oh, but that's a different gauge. That used to be stuck in the water somewhere, then meant nothing to us. Went up to like 6 meters, I think. Oh no, the one at Governor Stirling High School goes up to 6 meters. Yeah. And this is the pool that I came down thinking, well, we must be at Jimpiting now. And I looked on the side and there was no Jimpiting, and I got all depressed again. And then I was at Leatherheads. Oh, okay. Jimpiting must have been that thing way back there somewhere, you know. I missed Jimpiting completely. Is it? It's the end of the pool, is it? Yeah, like 11 Ks now. Yep. And you got these logs in the river here, yeah. Branches, at least not really long, are they? Well, that's a log. I think I like going straight here. It's a bit sticky both ways, yeah. You gonna try left? Okay. Yeah, it's about half and half. I think this is good, but yeah, you'll be fine. You want to come over here as soon as possible, I think. That's easy. Pretty good, was it? Nice. Same, yeah. Either's good. Yeah. I didn't hit anything. But that'll be a good spot if someone's stuck on the one, then you go the other. See what I mean? That nowhere have we had to make a decision where there was a wrong way and a right way. It's just anywhere's fine from here. There's the ram doe. But that's from Possults, so I think that's where you get confused, because it's like 5 minutes from cobblers, but like 5 Ks to Possults from here. Yeah? Isn't this the pool above Leatherheads here? Okay. That was Boomerang Pool behind us, wasn't it? Oh, that wasn't Boomerang Pool. Okay. So there's 3 pools down here then. Yeah. I don't think this little stick in front of us is the one. It doesn't look as familiar as the one. but there was a stick just like that that I hit with Steve, with Pete. Remember, I was going sideways down the river talking to him about, oh, there's that, blah, blah, blah. And I hit it on the side of my boat, right on my cockpit, and I stabilized and I was fine. And I said, right, that's what you have to be prepared for in the tea trees. Very good example, ha ha ha. And I've seen that stick twice in the race now, twice more in the race. And I've gone, that's Pete's stick, yes. It was after a pretty hard section in the tea trees, and we're paddling just like this, and it was 2 meters. And I was hooning down the side of him, and I just went side on to him and went, oh yeah, da 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 da, bang! I've seen it now a few times, yeah. And I wouldn't have hit that thing at 2 meters though. Yeah, right. Right's where you end up. Here's Dave's bank thing, but you don't need to, you'll be fine. Yeah. Everybody portaged this in the race. It's a no-brainer though, I mean, it's easy. All the ski guys were jumping over the log, getting out and hopping over the log. That's the one I reckon he said he went up on the bank. There's the gauge. The gauge is there. That's where the gauge used to be, right in front of you. Do you remember? That tea tree that you're hitting right now is the tea tree that we all used to hit. I believe this is the pool above Leatherheads here, isn't it? I think I got a hole in the boat again. Boat's leaking. Won't be shooting possils. Prospector. it's shallowing out. No flow to help us now. 7.5 kph. Surely that's Leatherhead's in front. Oh, maybe not.
13 Ks.
Right is right. should try left. Did you remember this one gets a bit dry? There's leatherheads. Leatherheads, rapids. Almost at the end of day one Avon descent. Cobbler pool, cobbler's pool, and below here. Only rapids in the TiTrees. Oh, great start too. The giant dome of a rock coming up around the corner here, which is the last obstacle of Avon descent day one. Right here. The old flatty. What a useful gauge that is, out of the water. Alrighty. Yep. I'm in agony, so I want to finish as quickly as possible now. TiTrees coming up. So blockage number one, clear. Two more blockages on the side here. And the channel off to the left, coming up in 3, 2, 1. Ding. Watch the river turn. Today. So we've got two overhangs coming up. The first one you can duck if it's the same as last year's. Second one not so much. So this first one looks pretty low though. But we've ducked it in the past, so I'm just gonna go really slow up to it. Oh yeah, it's the same. You should have plenty of room, but just be careful. Yeah, plenty of room. Ooh, you made it by a millimeter. Did you mean to do that close? Okay. Okay, cool. And that was my other little shortcut there. Now, we used to smash up on these logs here, so I'm going to do the same thing and break through here on the left. It's good. Go slow. Yeah, just in case you whack into that stuff. Yeah, this is the one that was lower. It's higher now, though. We'll be fine. It does push you around though. Oh. Taking the narrow bit, Dad, what are you doing? Oof. You're only just making those, eh? So like if you get pushed sideways, you're in a bit of trouble. Yeah, that's why I went in the middle there, because I saw the water going that way. Alright, now it's just a dead tree decision. Well, it depends. 0.4, we should be able to go anywhere, we should be able to go straight. But, I think I'll take the dead tree decision shoot anyway, and see what it's like. Because it is a hard little, you got to grab the tree and move around it. You took it with us last year. Oh no, you didn't come last year, yeah. Oh, I showed you on the video though, yeah. We're not there yet though, because there's no dead trees. Push on the right side here. Squeeze through the right side, is what I should have said. get your pedal on the tree technique down. Here we come. Dead tree decision. So if you want to go straight, you've got the option of straight left, straight right, or far right. And so here's the dead tree decision cheat sheet here. So this is where I'm going, and your ways are all down there. Coming, yeah. So you'll just have to grab this tree and maneuver your boat around it as we get there. But it's pretty simple if it's still the same as before. You just go really slowly. Right here is where it is. Hard left. Yep. Scrape down. That's right, you're slow up on the logs there anyway. So you can use your hands to get yourself around there, which we were doing in lower water. Oh yeah, I don't know about double. But now you know though. In low water, this was the only way. Definitely the way today. Hey, fine. That's better than my way. Just look up there, there's no water. Because the right-hand way splits into three, and so each of the three has bugger all water in it. That was it behind us, as I was saying. I was one of the three. You've still got two more channels on our right. But they're both tiny. Check it out. That's the second one. And then the one more channel coming just here. All of them are just nothing channels. I mean, that's definitely nothing. This is the best one. But look how much water is in it. Oh, this is the ford. Yep. So dead tree decision is where you make your choice which part of the ford you want to pop out at. Yeah. Oh yeah, well the middle channel's the way normally, that's the whole point. The middle channel's where everybody goes always. But that little cheat chute on the left is a much better way in low water. And no one really takes it. Well, now they do because they follow me down. Watch this, left. Yeah. I remember that. That was there with about six boats on it. Nah, I was by myself when I got here. Well, I mean, it was day two now, wasn't it? Yeah, I was still by myself because I had already wiped everybody in my grid off in those tree, at dead tree decision, in fact. There were six boats that went straight and they were all stuck. And I said, guys, it's too late. You should have gone left. Watch my videos next year. In Possults board pool above Possults board. Two hours. 17 Ks, exactly. Rocky! Could be worse. Cheers. Get your brace strapped in. Gotta let the rocks do their thing, eh? I hit the one at the top. I came in wrong. Yee-hee. 2 minutes, 2 hours and 10 minutes. Beep. Exactly 17 Ks. Where you are there, if you slide in that way, usually it's a nice spot to get out of.